So it's been right now from few weeks right now that I have been really posting videos on my YouTube channel, and I just really wanted to share that why am I doing it right now and what is my actual purpose and motivation behind doing all that kind of stuff. So before to really start about describing about why am I doing this, I really want to just get through the history about this about couple of years behind right now. So when I was really in high school, probably around 12, during that time I have really no idea about programming and all that kind of stuff. I really don't know anything about programming. I absolutely wasn't really loving or really hating the programming and all that kind of stuff, and actually didn't have any knowledge regarding what we can do with the programming and all that kind of stuff. But actually I was really into some sort of an astronomical thing, like studying the space and planetary system, studying the galaxies and all that kind of stuff from my high school. So I really thought that why wouldn't I really become an or to start my career in some sort of an space department. And there was really an high option that I really imagined to like work with the ISRO or work with the NASA and all that kind of stuff. But when I really saw that their strategic process of my mind just immediately said that no, I don't want to become this. So for the next 6 months I really just started to discover what else is the next thing that is really true in me and which I can really do. So within that time frame I really discovered the person's biography name as Elon Musk. We all know eventually people really call him the real life Tony Stark. Yeah, and I also really did study about him, that how he really grew up in South Africa, how he really started his X.com, Confinity, PayPal, then really started Tesla and SpaceX. I was really fascinated by his journey and all that kind of stuff. And during that phase also I really was having some sort of the ideas which I'm really even now thinking of doing a patent on it. The idea is actually about electrical carrier contact for the high speed railways. I mean extremely high speed railways, which really travel up more than 400 kilometers per hour, and the second one is of hologram touch interface. But during that time frame I was having no any some sort of an idea about business idea, that business idea or career plan that I have really do. So I really found out that during the research and all that kind of stuff, I really found out that the computer is such a thing that really interests me a lot. I mean, the primary reason behind getting fascinated with the programming is like it really gives me a freedom of doing whatever I want, like creating the stuff which I really imagine and bringing out in the reality to the whole world out there. And as always, the joy of creating is also really nice and cool stuff. So in the late 2018 I really came up with a two business ideas, that about first one is about collecting the users' data by the smartphone, wearable and IoT devices, and suggesting them the preventive measures about how they can really make their life much more meaningful. And the second one is about creating a next social networking site for memes. And yeah, so I was really excited and enthusiastic about making it, but I didn't really know anything about how can I really make it. Then I just really started to search about how can I really become a software developer, and particularly software developer in the sense like exactly particularly like how can I develop my own websites, how can I really make the Android and iOS application to really deliver my idea and my creativity through my products to the whole world out there. So I really started to just study the web development from I think March 2019 is the correct time frame, because the reason I really started so late is that I really got my laptop so pretty much late at the time. But I was really studying all the theoretical and all that kind of stuff prior to it, about how to become a developer, what is actually the downfall, what is the upside, what is the die, what is the turnover, and all that kind of stuff. So in short, analyzing the pros and cons of becoming a both and all that kind of stuff. And in the previous video I really discovered about how I really learn all that kind of stuff, right? You can check it up by in the right corner, I button. In the late 2018, probably around I think October 2018, I just really saw a movie called Social Network. It was a movie based on how Mark Zuckerberg really started the Facebook. Actually, but that movie is not really factually correct. But one thing that I really was stuck, and that movie really just breathed me, was the scene of Facemash and hacking, all that kind of stuff. And when I really saw that scene, I was like, man, this is really cool. Like, I'll surely one day make it up the project of this kind of thing. So starting from 2019, so starting from the March 2019 up to the October 2019, I really finished learning all the from the front end to the back end, and completing the full stack learning and all that kind of stuff. But I was really being actually still now I'm really being a tutorial purgatory, all that kind of stuff. So tutorial purgatory is actually one phase when you really trying to learn the web development or software development, you eventually go again and again in the jump from one tutorial to another tutorial and do nothing about making your own projects and all that kind of stuff. So finally I did take a stand on my own about making something really challenging and making something really unique that is really exciting enough and which can be really shared to the whole world. So like I really described, the Facemash was the one thing. The reason I also chose Facemash was because I really wanted to gather enough of my skill that I could really easily make my own products for my own startup, as really earlier described. So starting from right now, I'll be really posting videos about how I will really getting out of the tutorial purgatory, how I will really the warm fuzzy tutorial comfort zone, and just explore the uncharted coding territory. Because as it is really said that the once you really kind of really start to doing your own project, you really Google the shit out of it. I mean, really a lot of thing is really gonna be happen. So I'm really excited around it. And the more so the primary reason about doing it on YouTube is like, and one of the primary reason that I also really doing YouTube is like to keep myself accountable, and just to go in a steady, regular and consistent flow. I actually dropped out of the college in April 2019. Why? That itself really deserve another topic, and I'll really surely really make a video on it. And also I was really feeling pretty alone doing learning all the things on my own, and I was having literally no one that I could really communicate with each other. And I did really contacted my friend about if anyone is really interested in working with my project. I really DM'd everyone out there on Instagram and Facebook and whatever possibly all my friend list was, but no one really seemed really kind of interested in working with me. So I really decided to really just go all alone and go all in. So, and one of the thing is like, there is a really critical problem of the critical challenge of becoming a real developer from and escaping from tutorial purgatory to actually really making something which you can really show up to the whole world and really can make a complex thing really easily. And that is what up to date till now on internet, especially on internet, it is not really upload that how you can really get out of the tutorial purgatory, or no one has really ever been shared their experience about how they can really make their complex process easy and simplified, how they can make their own gigantic social networking sites. Although there are really tutorials on making a clone of front end, but there is nothing like making a full vast detail about making a social networking site, taking from the UI design, from the front end coding, and to the back end architecture. So I really decided on my own to go and make it and just share it with the whole world out there. So me just being alone, selfish, I can really share what I've experienced and what I've learned to the whole world out there, and even others can really get benefited from it. And primarily supporting myself monetarily as little as I can, and also I really want to buy a Mac Mini for iOS development, because I really hate Apple for like enforcing the developers to buy the Apple products to make an iOS thing, because I really want to make an iOS apps by learning the Swift and Xcode, because I think it will be really helpful for my startup in the later stage. And I really forget to mention that the early startup which I really mentioned I'll be actually launching it in 2021 probably. Let's hope so, we'll do it in the right time. So these were only my primary reason that I really just chosen to become a web developer and software development. I don't really like web development just for coding. I actually like it because I can really make a bunch of cool, interesting products which I can really share to the whole world out there. And I really wanted to convert my business ideas into app, and web development and the app development is one of the way to implementing it. And obviously coding is not the thing that I really want to do for the rest of my life, but that is a later topic, which that is what really deserve another separate topic about why am I saying this right now. So I hope you really like this video. Make sure to share this video on every other platform and stay subscribed to this channel, and have a nice day.